you have a college-age kid graduating in the spring, the time for them to start looking for a job is really now. How do you stand out in a market, though, that's about to be flooded by new grads? Inspiration coach and keynote speaker Shannon Oleen joins us now with your top ideas. Number one, Shannon, you say is video.
Yes, absolutely. So here's the thing, like the rules have changed a little bit for 2018. So everything now is about company culture and employee engagement and also the experience with employees. How do they interact with each other? So companies want to know your personality. So do a video, shine, show your personality on camera, show how articulate you are and how pulled together you are. Now, see, here's the thing, in 2018, everybody has a smartphone, right?
Right.
You can easily take video on your phone. You can add, there are free apps where you can add like an intro, an outro, you can add copy or text like on the video and then package it up and send it in. And if you don't have a smartphone, then no worries. You can still go to the library.
Well, you know someone who has
one. You have a friend who knows, has one.
Do you attach a video link then with the resume that you're emailing them?
Yeah, I think there's a couple of ways that you can do it. So you can disseminate the information by creating a YouTube channel or by putting the information on your resume as a link to click on that they can go to, or even just in the email body when you're sending it over.
What about people who try to get creative to actually meet the boss, like calling after hours and speaking directly to the person who's doing the hiring and kind of circumventing HR? What's your take on that?
Sure, great question. So here's what I always say. The rules still apply in this area, okay? So you wanna read that job description front to back, very beginning to the very end, left, right, up, down. And so you wanna pay attention to what the rules are asking you to do. You want to follow those rules and then see how far that gets you.
And then if you know someone who knows someone who knows someone, is it okay to try to just get your name in there?
Or yeah. So I think this kind of goes with my next point of follow-up. Like, follow-up is king. I can't tell you, 99% of the time, candidates or applicants never follow up. In fact, I actually kind of like do a little trickster trick with with applicants. Sometimes I will just wait to see who actually follows up, and then those are the candidates that I actually pay attention to. Because I want to know, as the employer, that you're really invested or interested in the job.
When you say follow-up, do you mean a formal thank you card, or do you mean a call, an email? What, as an employer, do you look for and are people looking for?
Anything that shows that to me that you are going to go the extra mile. So if you find employees or bosses on LinkedIn, or if you write a handwritten thank you note and either give it that day or follow up in the mail, or even just in a simple email as well. But and just think about, how are you going to make yourself stand out, differentiate yourself?
I want to ask you about social media. Obviously, you've got to be careful what brand you're putting out there, because anything you do on social media. My other question is, do you start following potential bosses on Twitter or try to friend them on Facebook? What's your take on that?
Yeah, so this is interesting because this is a fine line, right? You don't want to appear stalkerish, right?
Yeah.
But you definitely want to show that you're interested and engaged in what the company is doing. And so I definitely want to take a look at like social cues from what the employer or the hiring manager says or does. And you might even ask the question, say, hey, would it be okay to follow the company profile on LinkedIn? Or would it be okay to actually personally connect with you on LinkedIn? And I keep using LinkedIn is the reference because LinkedIn is kind of the Facebook of the professional community, right? And if you don't know what LinkedIn is, I would highly recommend that you still, that you get on it, buff up your profile, et cetera, et cetera. But yeah, follow the social cues, number one. And number two, yes, I definitely would say it's not going to hurt you to keep trying to make that connection.
Shannon Oleen, keynote speaker, inspiration coach, always great to have you here. Give us some guidance so we can help the young people in our lives make good choices and really nail that job. Thank you.